Shutter control. Configuring each module for each shutter. After having included it, now we are going to configure each module. The initial values that we are going to take for the modules included are: for module 2, hidden module for AC C-Wave Plus Cubino shutters with consumption measures. Name: classroom shutter. Room: classroom and opening. Length channels: shutter, consumption, temperature. Module 3, multi-sensor 6-in-1 C-Wave Plus Generation 5 Aeon Labs. Name: classroom luminosity. Room: classroom. Length channels: movement, temperature, luminosity, humidity, ultraviolet. Values: while in movement, they can be vibration and movement. Temperatures in degrees Celsius. Luminosity, luxes. Humidity, percent. Configuring the limit switches with C-Wave parameters. Inside the device configuration, we're going to the tab C-Wave parameters. In command classes, we're going to select command class configuration. In command name, we can ask for a module with a get or send him an order with set. In this case, we're going to send an order for self-calibration, selecting configuration set. Use box parameter number, we will have every parameter available for this module explained. The more parameters a module has, the more the quality will be, and we will have more actions available. In this module, the self-calibration is in the parameter 78, force shutter calibration. In value 1, we're going to set the information to send. In this case, we will have to send a 1 in order for the calibration to start. Once every parameter is completed, we're going to send them to the module clicking on send. At this moment, the module will calibrate the shutter. First, it will raise the shutter until it detects no power consumption. This will mean it arrived at the top. Then it will lower the shutter and measure the time it takes to reach the bottom. Once again, it will raise the shutter, since rising and lowering times are different in heavy shutters. Creating a virtual actuator. Many times it will be necessary to create virtual devices. They work as physical devices, but they don't really exist. In this case, we are going to create a virtual peripheral that will allow us to control both shutters at the same time. To create this peripheral, we are going to Configuration, Add or Remove a Peripheral. And in this window, we are going to click on Other Types of Peripherals. Another window will appear with many choices. We are going to select the first. It is called Scene. A new window will appear and we will fill it with this data. Name: shutters. Use: electrical devices. Room: studio and classroom. Values: we will add 6 values. This will allow us to make 6 scenes with the shutters. Scene 1, closed. Related actions: shutter for studio and classroom closed. Scene 2, 20% open, with the shutters half open. Scene 3, sun. Related actions: studio shutter and classroom shutter positions towards sun. The next scenes are: scene 4, 50% open. Scene 5, 70% open. Scene 6, shutters fully open. Creating timing macros. Before creating the rules, we will have to create the timing macros for turning on the lamps. For this, we will go to the lamp, config, devices, studio lamp, config. We will click on the third tab, macros, and we will add the macro for turning on lamps for 2 minutes. We will set the name turning on 2 minutes and we will save it. Creating manual scenes, controlling shutters with push buttons. From any C-Wave push button, we will be able to create scenes. With a simple push, we will be able to control multiple devices without having to send orders individually. In this chapter, we will create 2 scenes. The C-Wave push button module can tell the difference between a short push and a long push, double click and also releasing. This will allow us to create up to 16 different scenes. In this case, we will use a short push, left key, V1 rise, and P2 lower. Creating the rules. To create the scenes, also known as rules, we will have to go to the configuration for the module push buttons, in system configuration, devices, scenes push button, and configure. After configuring the device push button and setting it in the room scenes, we're going to activate the 4th tab, associated rules, and we will click on new rule. The configuration is going to be name, good night, enabled, group, default, not timely criteria. Scenes push becomes equal to 1 when pushed. Actions, studio shutter closed, classroom shutter closed, studio lamp, color white, 2 minute macro, then off, studio classroom lamp, off, corridor lamp, off. Creating automatic scenes, shutter control from external devices. Now we have even greater potential. We can create scenes or rules automatically. They will be executed according to parameters from other peripherals. In this case, we will have an external peripheral that will allow us to lower the shutters according to the phase of the day. To create this rule, we will have to read an external device. In order to do that, we have to create before a new one, go into system configuration, add other kinds of peripherals, weather, and we will select sunrise create. This will create a peripheral that will indicate the sunrise time and the sunset time according to the geographic location. We will set a name for it, related to the function that it's going to perform. In this case, sunrise and sunset, 40 minutes. We will set it in the room weather. We will then pick the city where it's going to be placed. In this case, Ferrol, Spain. In values, we will have, it's night time, it's getting dark, it's sunrise, it's full day. It's night is activated when the sun is set, it's full day when the sun has been risen. The other two is the interval of time when the sun gets up and down. This interval is going to be configured by us. In sunset duration, we're going to set it to 40 minutes. So it's getting dark, it's going to last 40 minutes. Keep in mind that the program should close the shutters automatically 40 minutes after sunset if the next day is a working day, or 60 minutes if it is a holiday. To do that, we will go to System Configuration, Programming, Rules, New Rule. We will feed the data with the next information, name, it's getting dark 40 minutes, group, default, No timely criteria. Criteria. Sunrise and sunset, 40 minutes. Now equals it's night. And tomorrow becomes working day. Actions. We'll set other actions. The rule it's getting dark, 60 minutes, will be created in a similar way, changing sunset and sunrise time and working day for holiday. The rule it's getting dark. Creating automatic scenes for shutter protection against wind. Shutters and sunshades can have many problems when the winds are too strong. They can be destroyed in few minutes in a wind burst. We will create a rule to protect them when the winds are above 14 meters per second, which is 50.4 kilometers per hour. Above that, the sunshade of the shutter will be closed. In the configuration, the rule will be name, strong wind, group, default. No time criteria. Criteria, if wind outside is above 14 meters per second. Actions, we will raise both shutters. The sun rays, specifically the ultraviolet radiation, can degrade furniture inside the house, also plastics, paintings, etc. To prevent this, we will have to create a rule that we will set the shutters in the sun position when it detects the level of ultraviolet radiation above 4. To do this, we will set the AeoTech Multisensor 6 in a place where it can measure directly the sun rays. The configuration for this rule will be name, ultraviolet in excess, group, default, no timely criteria. Criteria, ultraviolet in classroom becomes higher than 4. Actions, shutters in sun position.